Alright guys, for my viewers, I am going to rate us out to my buddy Kramer. It's our podcast, our weekly podcast. I'd really appreciate if you guys stick around, listen to it, let us know what you think, give us some constructive feedback. Also check out his YouTube channel. And when I get done with the podcast, I'll be back to do more Diablo carries and lots of shenanigans. And Batman just won 2,000 gold. Damn. The slots are playing hard tonight, bro. I've won 4,000. Kramer won 28,000. That's another 2,000 that somebody bought or won. I'm telling you, bro. Playing hard today. Alright, but after the raid, after the raid, I send you to Kramer. Kramer's probably going to send me back, or send you to me back, and I'm just going to leave my stream on, and we'll do more Diablo stuff.
That's awful presumptuous of you.
Are you even live yet?
Yeah.
Shut your mouth and do your business.
I am live.
I don't see it live.
I'm already on.
Oh, it's there, baby. Alright, I'm all shared out. I'm switching it over. Hello, everybody. And welcome back to another episode of STFU, I'm Driving. This is the podcast show where we talk about current events, personal stories, our personal opinions, experiences. Yeah, that's pretty much it. And with me, as always, I got Nick, Nasty, and Benita. Say hi, guys.
What's up?
Hello.
Yeah.
I'm too late.
Too late for what?
Trying to get these people over to you.
Oh, slow, yeah. Man. Get them over here.
Shit's all slow, dude.
Not too late. I wanted you to
introduce yourself like you just did to them, to my peoples.
Oh, well, whenever they get here.
This is, everybody
this
knows.
This is a huge Diablo community. Wonderful guys.
All right.
Very supportive.
Very supportive. Good stuff. If you're into Diablo, anybody catching this video? Nasty does.
Cats.
Nasty does a lot. And, yeah, make sure you like and subscribe to the channel on YouTube. Anyways, how was your guys' week?
It was okay. I mean, good week, I guess. Things didn't really go as planned, but other than that, it was good.
They rarely do.
Hello. Nothing ever goes as planned.
Well, hello there.
Well, hello there.
Look at all these Raiders.
Welcome, Nasty's Raiders.
Hello.
Appreciate you hopping over to check out the old podcast.
Yeah.
So anyways, I don't know, I had a pretty sweet weekend. I went out to, so for the first time, well, I say for the first time, you came up a couple weekends ago and caught the first Buckeye game with me out here, so.
Yeah.
But I went out to one of Whitney's friends that she hangs out with at the bars when she goes out. He was playing some live music. And so we went out there and watched him play. And while we were there, I noticed a couple guys.
Good looking.
Hey, thank you for that. I noticed that a couple guys were over there watching the Ohio State game.
And hell yeah.
And so I watched the second half with them, and they were all about Ohio State. It was like there was like five of us over there.
Damn.
Nice.
Hey.
You get some new friends or like, you know.
Oh yeah.
Dude, that game was nuts.
Yeah, it was a little too close for me. Thank you for those, Tommy.
I was like, I even said like straight up.
We play that team up north that way.
If we played like
we'll
that.
Lose.
Oh yeah, no doubt. No doubt about that.
Yeah. That was insane. I honestly thought they had lost. I think everybody did, really.
Well, we were sitting there, and this guy came up, and he wanted to be funny, and he started rooting for Notre Dame. And, like, at like the guys that I was with, there are some big biker dudes because it was bike night up there. Mm-hmm. And yeah, they were doing auctions and stuff for combat vets. Because there's like a couple MC clubs around here that are exclusively combat veterans, and they do a lot of cool stuff. So yeah, gotta love it. But yeah, they started rooting. I mean, I thought the one guy was like, "Get the fuck out of here!" I was like, "Oh shit!" I was like, "Guys, it's a football game." And I'm like, "But he's right, though. You gotta get the fuck out of here with that."
Yeah, don't get.
Yeah. So, I have a question related to the game, I guess, kind of, but it's about Notre Dame. So, I thought their collar was like navy and gold. Am I wrong? They're not. They're green and gold.
No, they were navy and gold. I don't know. The green might be a special.
Yeah, I think that was an alternate uniform.
Yeah.
I didn't. I never.
I tried to explain this like a few times yesterday that they're just using the one-off uniforms.
Yeah.
They are typically navy gold or navy and gold.
Right. Yeah, but I've never seen them wear green before, though.
Right. What Kimbo just said, they're away home game or different jerseys.
Yeah.
And I'm pretty sure that those jerseys in specifically were like those, like, you know, like when we wear the black and red and white ones.
Yeah. Like stuff, the for the blackout.
Like when we're at home. Yeah, exactly. This is what Notre Dame was doing. They're just showing off a different alteration of their jerseys.
Yeah. So I got
and they thought, you know, they were going to win.
Yep.
That's why they were showing off.
Well, they thought wrong. But yeah, I got to go out.
And isn't the luck of the Irish something to do with the green, all right? It's always no, green.
Nobody cares about what they got going on, Nasty. Anyways, no, I got to go out. We left Natalie and Whitney's friend's daughter here watching the two younger ones. And I went out with no kids for like 2 hours yesterday. It was,
well, yeah. Well, that must have been fun.
Yeah, and I got to watch, and then I had a piece of catfish that was flipping excellent and some red beans and rice.
Nice.
So I had a great Saturday night.
Hell yeah.
But
we ended up going up to see everybody yesterday, and we got to see the Starlink satellites again, so I got to share that with everybody up there. And
those are cool. So. Yo, did you see that that video that Nick shared? Let me see if I can pull that up real quick. Of the Starlink satellites over the years.
Yeah, like covering.
Yeah, that was crazy, wasn't it?
We've watched them three nights in a row. I think tonight is the first night we haven't watched them, and every time I see them, it's like still like amazing. It's still just amazing to see, though. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I still get thrilled every time I see them.
Nick got to see him with us this time up there. They were more spaced out, like that time I was describing to you. They're like, they weren't a little cluster together. They were like one. It's pretty cool.
Yeah. All right. So this is like
a
1 minute video. Let me see if I can pull this bastard up.
It was pretty awesome. If you guys have not, listeners, if you guys haven't checked out the Starlink satellites,
yeah, you definitely
download the app or whatever, or
go to the webpage. Just Google, find Starlink satellites.
Especially if you have kids, it's cool to have them there watching.
Check it out.
Or if you're just a space nerd like me,
right?
It blows my mind still that this is one guy that's changing the night sky like that.
Changing our night sky.
I would say it's one guy.
Yeah.
It's billions of his dollars.
No, you're right. Yeah.
One company.
I mean, obviously. Yeah.
I mean, it's no different. It's just like a private NASA. You know,
he's
got his own private NASA.
Oh,
my
God, that echo.
My God, that echo.
Fucking echo, dude.
All right. So we are going to definitely, probably after we're done recording this one, we're going to see if we can set up the Discord. All right.
Oh, it's back.
But here's that video that Nick shared.
Here's that video that Nick shared.
So this is the number of Starlink launches since 2019.
Look at him.
What the fuck?
Just wait.
Yeah.
There's supposed to be 42,000 at the end of this. He's got 5,000 up there right now, supposedly.
No, that looks way more than 5,000.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think this is a dramatized version of this.
Well, this isn't. Well, this isn't actual footage.
I just
look at them all. Look at them all.
Is it going to show?
And there's the trains, the satellite trains that we've seen.
So,
some are stationary and.
Well, some are like.
No, they're all moving.
Yeah.
But some are moving like away from the general direction of the rest of them.
So, yeah, that's kind of like a crisscross type thing, it looks like.
Yeah.
But you notice how there's none at the poles?
Right, I seen that. I thought that was strange.
Well, there at the end, there was stuff going by the poles, but yeah,
a little bit.
Well, that's because there's nobody up there.
Stuff, they didn't. Yeah, that's exactly the reason. There's literally nothing.
Or they're hiding something.
Population living there. They're hiding something.
I saw this video. Of
there are no poles. The world is not even flat. It's one of what like parallelogram.
I'm just like, so he's supposed to have 42,000 of these things like out around the earth. So like, don't you
not
think
yet. Not yet. He only has 5,000 out, right?
I said he's supposed to have.
Right. At the end of this, he's going to have 40.
What I'm trying to say is that going to somehow affect like airspace and stuff like that? Like, as far as, I mean, they would have to like, can they manipulate them? Like change their. How do they stop them? Like, if they need to get one down, is there any way to do that? Like, I don't know.
Yeah, they could do that.
If they put so many up there, then, like, you know, if we're going to launch something, then how would we not hit one, you know? I don't know. Just something I was thinking about randomly.
Just a Starlink satellite falls out of the sky onto your house.
Right, like.
It's like that that jet that they lost. Did you hear about that? I know we talked about it a little bit last time.
Did they find it?
Yeah, so you know where they found it?
In someone's backyard?
Yes. Like, yeah, it was really close to this dude's house.
It went missing off the coast? Is that the one you're talking about?
No.
Yeah, I was just joking about that. That's crazy, but that's actually true. I've seen nothing about it since we talked about it last time.
Benita, could you try unplugging your headset and plugging it back in? So what happened with it was the dude was flying this plane, right? And he thought that it was going to crash. So he ejected from it. And the plane corrected itself. Autopilot took over. And it flew till it ran out of gas.
Oh my god!
At which point it crashed like dangerously close to some dude's house. So I thought that was that dude's in trouble.
Yeah, for sure. Especially since he survived.
Right. Well, yeah. I mean, luckily he survived. That's a good thing. But yeah, the fact that he ejected and then the plane was just like, oh, no, we're good, man. Where are you going? Oh, well.
Oops.
Yeah. Plane's like, oh, no, wait, come back.
Right. Oh, well, what are you going to do?
Wow.
You know what I say? Once the planes start flying themselves, we're in trouble. but I don't know. There was something I wanted to talk about.
We'll never have jets and cars because people can't drive real cars.
I've seen something recently. It was like an air taxi type thing. They looked like little drone type helicopters, but they just had like a pod, you know, that people would like set in, and it had like propellers on the top, and it would just, I could definitely see something like that becoming a thing in the future for sure.
Yeah.
Right.
I mean, it is a thing now, but I mean, becoming like a popular thing.
Well, I don't know. No, they, they're working on like, crafts that can get you, what was it? I want to say it was from like New York to London by the time you can, like in 3 hours. It was like by the time you could finish watching Oppenheimer, you would be from the States to London.
Is it Oppenheimer or Oppenheimer?
Oppenheimer, whatever. You say tomato, I say tomato.
Yeah.
Like David Dreyfus.
Yeah. Just like David Dreyfus. Like David Dreyfus. So, I don't know. Good stuff, though. Damn it. I'm like floundering to remember what I wanted to talk about before I was reminded of that jet. Oh.
I don't know.
We were talking about Antarctica, right? So.
Yeah, we mentioned that after Starlink.
All right, so I found this video.
Hey, guys, check this out.
Nope, not that one. All right. I saved it. Saved it on TikTok. You know, I used to talk all kinds of shit about TikTok, but it's really
not too shab.
Yeah, I like it. All right, so I got this video here. The algorithm really, really gets me. All right, so we're gonna pull this up real quick. So this is Antarctica related. So check this out, guys. This is crazy, right? So this is like a Google map type thing of Antarctica. And the guy, he like, you know, he does the whole zoom in thing till he gets down to ground level. And check this out. Here we go. You gotta have the eerie music on too.
But she shaved her like whole face.
I did.
Why'd you do that?
I was feeling young. Yeah, I was feeling like I looked too old. The guy didn't card me at the bar yesterday, so I'm like, man, fuck this. So check like, this.
I'm pretty sure you were born in the last century.
So look at this.
Looks like cocaine on a table.
Look. What the fuck is that?
There's no fucking way.
What is that? What the fuck is that?
Why they don't want us up there?
Yeah.
Damn.
They're thawing out them crazy creatures.
Oh, what the fuck?
Yeah. I don't know about all that, man. Stay out of Antarctica.
Looks like a piranha alien.
It looks like a dinosaur, like a lizard. Like, aren't the lizard people already like?
I'm sure
alive and shit.
I'm sure they're
definitely
gonna.
Definitely lizard like the, people. That's what it is.
They'll bring that back and they'll
say
be like,
the truth
"Oh,
is stranger than fiction."
The bones don't line up, and it's the head of a llama or some shit.
Right. It was just a dodo bird.
Yeah, it's just a little dodo bird.
That doesn't even look real. It looks like something out of a fucking video game, bro. I want to see it again. Pause it on that picture. Like, it looked like it had armor on, like it was fighting in the Middle Ages or some shit.
Well, I'm sure they cropped it from something.
Yeah, I'm not even sure what, you know.
Can you, like, fast forward and then, like, pause it right there? What the fuck? It looks like it's got, like, it was, like, trapped on a net or something, like.
Yeah, I don't.
Looks like there's a body underneath it, under the water or something.
I don't know. I'd be surprised if that was real. You know what I mean? That's cool, though. I thought that was cool. I was like, what the fuck?
So how did some random dude, like, manage to find
that?
That
reminds me of that one boss from Destiny. Like,
yeah, something like that. Like, fucking,
yeah, like all the bosses
looks
in
like
Destiny.
Something out of a video
it's one
game
of the Cabal.
That shit is legit. Right. There's
like those random videos of people that find all sorts of weird things from zooming in on Google Earth. It's really
I like the ones where they find people fucking in an alley. Those are my favorite ones.
Oh my god, what do you look at?
I don't know. The internet
algorithm is fucked up.
Look,
I'm
was
tell you right now. I ain't never seen Google Earth, anybody zoom in from Google Earth and see somebody fucking in an alley.
I have been to some strange places on the internet, and I've been desensitized to all the weirdness, and now, like, I just need extra weird.
Jeez.
You know what I mean?
Nobody can wonder about people.
So you're the reason they make snuff films.
I don't like that stuff. Good God. Fuck. I can't watch that kind of shit. Yeah, I like weird stuff. I don't like gore. I can't watch gore.
Chris doesn't like normal porn. Like, he's been exposed to so much of it that he has to have, like, crazy, like, midget fucking horse porn.
It's pretty much what he was saying.
Yeah, that's a snuff film. Jesus.
Saying he's really got to get some extra
snuff
stuff.
Film. That's exactly what I'm saying.
I didn't know what it was, but now I know what a snuff
film is. Now let me ask you this. Who the hell goes to a porn site and looks up missionary? Nobody does that.
Some people might. That might be like a fucking thing. Right?
Oh, I don't know.
I don't know.
It's like just
they might only looking at it from the missionary angle.
They're like
certain position.
There's a few videos that they got saved where the woman just lays there.
You are not
and it's missionary, and nobody says
visiting a porno site. You're not conservative. You're looking for something that's.
That's true. Nobody that's gone to a porno site is a conservative.
You have a fetish or you got a niche. You want to see something specific.
I don't think just because you look at porn means you have a fetish or a niche. I don't think
that's
accurate.
Yeah, I don't think
that's
accurate at all.
You want to see titties in the ass.
Yeah. I get a lot of that throughout the day, too. It's only weird when the guy I work with catches me looking at it. So.
Oh, gee.
What are you going to do? Tell him, mind your own fucking business. Get back to work.
Not suited for work.
And, I hate those fucking videos that pop up on TikTok where, like, it'll be like, you know, it's cool, or listen to the sound my car's making. And there'll be like fucking chick moaning real loud.
Oh, yeah.
Nassie's got that happen once or so, too.
It's your vape.
See, when I get those, you look at, like, if you're out in public, anybody who looks, you just look at them and wink. Then they're uncomfortable. So.
Yeah.
You just you deflect the uncomfortable feelings off on someone else. So
I think I seen I honestly forget the name of the guys, but it's a group of friends and they're like all prank each other. Anyway, like one of them, they had like a porn site they were pulling up in like a park area, but they had like headset on, so they're just like sitting there like acting like nobody could hear it. It was pretty funny just to see everybody's reactions. Anyway. Random.
Yeah.
And then there's dead silence.
What?
Silence.
No, I was actually, if I'm gonna be honest, wasn't listening. I zoned out for a second.
I figured. It's okay. I'm used to that.
Well,
I knew she was going to say the
same thing.
I clicked over. I clicked over. Well, let me explain myself, right? I clicked over.
It's a man thing. See, no. It's a man thing. It's not just.
No, I clicked over to find the next video or the next topic or whatever we're going to talk about. And I clicked on Facebook. And the first thing I see is Nick's wife saying, "Let's go Steelers." And it just, I had to comment on it.
Yeah, it sucks, don't it? Oh. They suck.
Oh, they're literally the worst team in the league.
Yeah, and right next to the Browns and the Bengals.
No, Browns whooped ass
and
today.
Whatever team Nasty likes.
And the Jaguars.
Yeah, the Jags are like the only reputable team left.
No. Hey, how is Trevor Lawrence doing, by the way?
She's good. She's good.
Yeah.
I bet.
Jacksonville, did they lose today?
Yeah, we took the L.
I'm sure they didn't lose as bad as Denver did, though.
No, that looked like a college score.
Oh, yeah, I know, right? Fucking Russell Wilson. I don't know, buddy.
Like what, the whole state of Colorado.
Russell Wilson went to Denver?
Weekend.
What the fuck?
Oh, yeah.
Look
at Deion Sanders, man. I saw a thing that was like, this weekend was the biggest reality check for anybody watching Colorado.
Yep.
I was like, damn. I was like, I expected them to lose some games, but I was like, after watching them play their first couple ones, I didn't expect them to get like their ass beat like that.
Yeah, that's ego.
Yeah, I mean, Oregon is a top 10 football team, and they've been top 10 football team for many years
they have.
In a row. So
that's true.
They
they're getting a lot of good. Players up there, a lot of good
it's
prospects.
Weird how the whole college dynamic has changed. And like,
I mean, Colorado is pretty much was, you know, has never really been a big top 25 team. So for them to even break the top 25 with Deion is proof that he's doing something right over there.
That's
and I'm sure they'll probably end up in a decent bowl game.
Well, they're still
I mean, not like.
They're still in a winning season
like
right now.
Capital One Bowl or something like
if,
that.
If you looked at their record, I mean, I think I look back as far as like 20 years, and they had a losing season, like some pretty good stinkers over the last 20 years.
Yeah.
They had one year
absolutely
that was a winning season. I'm not sure what happened that year, but.
Luke?
Something. I don't know.
So
they had a winning season.
Joe Cool might not play tomorrow.
Why not? What happened with him?
I don't know. Something about like his vagina hurts or something.
His bajingo hurts.
Cry out spending that $250 million paycheck.
His jiny hurts. I'm just kidding. I'm a fan.
I know.
Anyway,
I know. I'm
fine. Have you seen? Damn it! It's gone. I can't remember what I was going to say.
Well,
$200 million.
I'd be out there in a fucking wheelchair on the field throwing the ball.
Damn right.
Right.
I wouldn't be fucking sitting on the bench for $250 million.
The Tiger King. Whatever his real name is.
Oh, yeah. What was with that, Joe Burrow?
He wrote a letter to Joe Burrow.
I saw that.
That he's always been known as the Tiger King, and that, you know, at least the least he could do is if he's going to use his name and title for like fame would be for him to pay like the $20,000 or whatever.
Yeah.
No, it wasn't. It was
10,000.
It said if you would help me
raise it,
the $10,000. Or
he said the Tiger King is
like,
my trademark. And
yeah.
I'm like, what the fuck?
Does he actually have it trademarked?
Who knows? Probably not. I would doubt it.
I don't know. Maybe
I would
Netflix
doubt it,
was
that,
involved.
That guy doesn't strike me as the type that would have the forethought to be like, hey, maybe I should trademark the Tiger King.
He's a pretty smart businessman, actually, dude. He made a lot of money doing the Tiger King.
Yeah? Well, the last deal he tried to make landed him in prison, so...
Oh yeah, that wasn't the smartest.
Yeah. So I don't know. You kind of feel bad for the guy. The docuseries that they put out really kind of put him in a, a good light. You know, people like that shit. They ate that. I remember when they came out with that. That was like all you saw on social media was the Tiger King.
I remember
Errol
watching
Baskins. Yeah. Killed her husband, whacked him.
Right. It's such a it was such a weird story.
I wish I didn't know we were going to talk about this because I would have worn my T-shirt. Says,
why men great till they got to be eight.
Why men great till they got to be eight. And it has a tiger on it.
Well, hell.
Wow, great. Now she's like, you really gonna wear that fucking shirt? I'm like, yeah, why not?
Hell yeah.
Feed me to a dog.
I'm gonna wear my shirt that says eating ain't cheating.
I would.
What the fuck, bro?
I love you, honey.
Rip Nasty's nipple right off.
He said, give me that nipple. So, I don't know. I don't even have a shirt that says that yet.
Yet. He said, yet.
Anywho.
Holy shit.
What else we got? What else do we have? I don't know. I wanted to ask Nick what you thought about the whole Antarctica thing. You got any opinions on that? Well, the fact that there's like parts of it that we can't fly over or get to. There's no like, because you know how America's like, let's just drill for oil.
Yeah.
And that's like, they've got, like they won't drill for oil. Bleh. They won't allow for oil drilling, which, I mean, I'm not going to argue that that's a bad thing. I just think it's strange, you know, that.
Right.
You know, we're willing to invade other countries for it.
I'm a huge conspiracy theorist. So
yeah,
theorist. I guess I just think along those lines a lot. But
trust no one.
This in. Question everything kind of sense.
We got that from watching the X-Files.
Yeah.
Trust no one.
Mulder and Scully.
Yeah.
I like the X-Files. My mom likes them too.
That was kind of.
Nasty started trying to watch them from the beginning, but it's kind of hard. They're kind of tacky when they first started.
Yeah, it is.
It reminds me a lot of Supernatural.
How dare you? Supernatural is one of the greatest television shows.
That's serious. They use the same kind of paranormal activities and shit and different lore.
Yeah.
From Supernatural. I think that what's his name? What the hell is his name? Heard of that shit. Right here.
What do you get at?
Yeah, the guy that wrote Supernatural, I think, got a lot of his inspiration from.
I was trying to compute that, and as I was writing, like, the letters don't even match. No, I'm kidding. Like, I didn't write a word at all. I don't know.
Threw some letters down there.
The creator of Supernatural got his inspiration from Supernatural. From
X-Files.
Is that
true? It could be.
I believe yes. I believe so.
I mean, people draw inspiration from all over.
No.
I think Supernatural drew their inspiration from like legitimate cases and local lore and stuff like that. Yeah, knock it off. God damn it.
Learn from
X-Files is. That was like me, like my dad liked to watch it. So when we would go to visit at his house, we would watch it with him. So I really liked X-Files. Yeah. My dear old pops. Anywho, let's see. I might have some more videos that we can look at. This one's just a funny one.
I'm not the only one that's drawn this conclusion.
Nobody said you should have been. It's I think that's not a very far leap to make.
That's a plausible assumption.
Maybe you saw this one, Nasty. I don't know. I Boston and the New York Yankees. So check this out.
I did not see this.
This is a I really wish they didn't like put the lettering on there, but kind of gives away what's about to happen.
Now the 3-2 swung on a pop foul.
Announcer hit by foul ball.
Oh. He said,
"Oh, it really hit me. I didn't know it was coming back that far." Now
he said, "Ow, ow."
Ow, I didn't know that was coming.
Oh my god.
Boink.
That hurt.
Yeah, it would. At least it hit like the table first and kind of that slowed it down a little bit. Them guys are way up there too.
Oh. Yeah.
Yeah. I like popped up. Probably yeah, my hair's wild. What's going on?
Yeah. 60 feet at least.
Yeah,
knocked
yeah.
Knocked him back at least two years.
Yeah.
About.
So. Yeah. That poor fella. The
3-2.
Oh.
I've never taken a foul ball to a face, but. He
that
took
was,
it like a champ, I'll tell
like
you that.
The most nerve-wracking thing. Like, I never played like baseball on a like a team level, but like, yeah, I played with neighborhood kids and shit, and always freaking pitching the baseball is always like the most nerve-wracking thing, because I always have the fear in the back of my mind that as soon as I release this ball, it's coming back at me.
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
Oh yeah, pitchers, like, man, that shit's dangerous as fuck.
I don't have the reflexes to dodge a 100-mile-an-hour ball coming at me. I can't dodge
a
wrench and I can't dodge a ball.
Can't dodge a wrench or a ball?
Nope.
You can dodge these balls.
I'll tell you what, back in my day, I could play some fucking mad dodgeball.
Yeah.
That's like one of my core memories. I remember there was one time, it was like 5-on-1. I was the last person remaining, and I was like in fourth grade. I literally jumped up and did the splits. So I like pegged two people with, I had two balls in my hand. I pegged two people with each one, and it got it down to like 2-on-1. And so the one person was like the best on their team. He fucking threw the ball at me as hard as he could, and I jumped up and did the splits, and it went right underneath me. And I picked up a ball when I landed and like kind of like sidearm through it and barely grazed his foot and got him out. Uh-huh. And then like turned around and the ball that he had thrown at me that went underneath me, it had bounced off the auditorium wall and had rolled back to me. So I basically turned around and grabbed that and turned back around and threw it and then freaking got the last person out. So it was like a 4-person swing. That's like a core memory for me.
So,
I don't know why. I haven't thought about that.
I was
that
like
in
just
years.
Take me out already.
So, as you're explaining that, like in my mind, I'm seeing like John Wick. the way you're like fucking headshot.
That's how it felt. Like the only thing I was missing was like a trench coat.
Yeah.
Oh
like
gosh.
for all the cool slow motion moves. The trench coat like spiraling around me.
That's the Matrix, but that's applicable.
Yeah, but it's, cool,
it's applicable. Applicable.
After John Wick wears a trench coat.
No, he wears a suit. He's got class, man.
Oh. Well, you can have a trench coat with a suit.
What? I gotta go.
Gee, what? What if it rains?
I don't know, Nick. I guess. I guess
they kind of
right.
do it on suits, kind of.
Yeah, I guess. Cassiel wears a trench coat, since we're on the subject of Supernatural tonight.
Chris, did you see that picture of Brandon in the suit?
Yes, I did. It was very sharp. You guys look good.
It was all done up. We paid like $15 for that suit for him.
Oh, shit.
Nice.
Golly. Not too shabby for 15 bucks.
It was, Yeah, it was the rest of the that shopping trip that was expensive. I think I spent like $400 something on funeral clothes.
Oh shit.
Jeez.
Yeah, man.
But luckily that's on the rear view.
Yeah.
Although, well, right. Sort of
kinda.
Yeah. You know what I mean with that. It's still yeah. kinda always there, but
yeah. No, it stays with you. It hurts. It hurts a little less as time goes on.
Through all of her stuff whenever my aunts fly in again.
Yeah,
he's got like a bunch of shit to go through.
Yeah, that's the best part.
Yeah, freaking.
I imagine
like, what the hell do we do with all this stuff?
I imagine that's kind of like depending on how you look at it. You go into it, you know, and you find some stuff, and.
I mean, yeah, you'll definitely find some shit. And what's crazy is like, you know, throughout all this hanging out and shit over at my dad's house, I found out that so when I was like 11 years old, maybe 10, it was as soon as I moved to my dad's house, I went out in the woods. Cause you know, back then, uh-huh. like right when I moved to my dad's, I didn't have any gaming systems or anything. So I was just out walking through the woods all the time.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
I found this stick and it had like a little dog leg to it. And so I took my dad's Dremel and I carved a mushroom shape into the top of it
uh-huh.
and like used the Dremel to put all the like spore spots and everything on it. And okay. Then I like lacquered the top and everything. And it, like,
where are we
it
going with
really
this, Nick?
Cool fucking, well, it was just a really cool walking stick.
Oh, okay.
And then I just found out like throughout, you know, hanging out in my dad's garage that he still fucking held on to it through all these years.
Oh, really?
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, that is cool. Yeah. I was gonna make some joke about you carving penises into sticks and.
No, it's like what do they call those mushrooms? The
morels.
Yeah.
The morels.
Kind of looks like that.
Right on. Those look like penises, though.
Does he do mushroom hunting and stuff for morels?
Those are truffles,
know.
Aren't they?
No.
A truffle is...
I don't think so.
Literally called a morel.
Yeah, it's a truffle.
Morel mushroom.
Morel.
Morel mushroom. People pay like a lot of fucking money for those.
Yeah,
that's
a truffle.
$50 a pound or something.
Yeah.
They're a black spring truffle. Yeah,
truffle mushroom.
If you could find... Oh, I guess... Is a truffle a mushroom? Well, we're about to learn something, or I'm about to learn something new today. Is a truffle a mushroom?
Careful where you go with truffle.
The old truffle shuffle? Why? Mm-hmm. Wait a minute, why?
Truffle butter, I don't know, just be careful.
Truffle butter?
Yeah.
Is it nasty? Now I gotta look it up.
Don't Google it.
It's too late.
We got an Urban Dictionary this.
It's in a fucking song, so I had to Google it. I don't know, I can't remember what song
this is actually truffle.
I found in the Urban Dictionary.
This is truffle. That's actual butter. Truffle butter urban definition. All right, this is, oh boy, here we go. Hang on to your man. This game is such truffle butter. Is it like poop? Does it mean poop?
No, it involves sexual things.
A slang term for the bodily excretion that occurs when switching between anal and vaginal intercourse. A reference to the tan,
yikes,
buttery substance of all.
Oh, what the fuck?
That's truffle butter.
How did you know that? Oh.
How did I know that?
Why did you take us there?
What the fuck?
Because he said truffle, and I said, be careful what you Google with truffle. And then...
Well, here we are, folks.
We're out
He's
here
apparently looking
out of
up
space,
truffles.
Minding our own business, and Bonita's like, yard sale.
I do believe we've hit...
Dark alley.
We've hit rock bottom here, folks. the rock bottom of this podcast.
You're welcome.
So,
it was in a song one time, and... or something, and then it was like truffle butter on my pussy or something was part of the song. And
you gotta make sure you clean yourself up.
Send it in Snapchat, apparently.
slang.org.
Pistory is going to be like all kinds of like variants of truffle butter, but he's only looking at it for the storyline.
Yeah. It's like, I only care about the story.
Like, how did we get to the truffle butter as well? Yeah. Interested in.
I want to know the events leading up to and after the truffle butter.
Do we have to go to the store first?
I mean, what was wrong with the sink?
Buy him dinner first.
Oh, it's a Nicki Minaj song.
Is it?
Yeah, let's see.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
It was released last year. The actual song is called Truffle Butter.
That's not the one then, because this was a long time.
So the song actually refers to the expensive French delicacy slathered on meats. So the meats is the vagina in this song.
Apparently.
Refers to a tan substance.
They have the meats. They mean they have the meats.
It says, according to the Urban Dictionary, the term truffle butter refers to the tan substance. Feces mixed with... excretions.
I don't want to hear it no more.
You're gonna hear it. This is my fucking podcast.
Fucking truffle butter yourself.
Close your ears if you don't want to hear.
I got headphones on.
It says it's well established. It's well established that poop in the vagina area is not sanitary or safe.
That is true.
So there we go, folks. We've learned something new today. I do apologize for that.
We all knew that.
I don't have a vagina, so I don't know.
I mean,
you're putting shit in multiple spots. Whole shit's only supposed to come out of one hole.
There you shit. Go.
So what you're saying is
that one movie that weird guy's like, I don't know shit's why God would go put a playground next to hole. A sewage facility.
Oh, that was Grandma's Boy, wasn't it?
Any holes. That's what it means.
Maybe.
Or no, It was that weird fella, and he was like newly wed, but he didn't want to have sex. He was all weird about having sex with his wife. And he's like, oh, it's so slippery, like it was a bad thing. Oh man.
Shit.
Anywho.
Crazy.
I'm shocked that none of y'all knew what that was, to be honest.
Nope.
I'm shocked that I know what it is now.
Just as accurate.
Yeah. So. Anyways.
Anyway, we were talking about a walking stick, and we ended up there.
Yeah. Oh, the truffle butter. Yeah, that's why we tagged the ADHD in these videos, because... My God.
All right. So I just came up with the name. It's Nick's Mushroom Tip Walking Stick Adventure.
Ooh, that sounds
the mushroom like... tip. The mushroom tip walking stick.
Yeah.
That's got a certain ring to it.
Kinkiest.
All right.
We might get some random views for that.
Yeah, people. I'll pay you $1,000 really for that walking stick. I need to fuck it now.
I need this walking stick mushroom tip. I don't know.
We're going to have to start selling the mushroom tip walking stick.
Right.
So, there's a whole lot of horny people out there.
Oh, see, I was being innocent about it. That's gross.
It's just like a broom with a dildo on the end of it.
Sorry.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I was literally thinking about these cute little morel mushrooms, or like these, you know, the little red ones with white spots and shit. No, you guys are down a different path.
You know, you talk about a shitty job. You ever wonder how much a dildo dipper makes?
No.
Probably less an hour than one cost.
I've seen videos where they dildo dip.
Oh.
Yeah.
What's up, girl?
That was probably one of the funniest things that Gap was seeing the old ladies picking dildos from the Spencer's area.
Why?
Huh?
Kramer's talking to a kid, I think.
Olivia came in and she's supposed to be in bed for about an hour now. And she came in here to ask me, you want to ask? She came in to ask me if hockey was a real game.
So, well, that yes, depends on who you ask, I guess.
Hockey is a real game. It's a sport. It is a sport. You ever watch hockey?
It is. Yes, I know what hockey is.
Well, them guys, like,
I'll tell you what, hockey fans are like some of the most hardcore fans.
They're crazy.
Yeah. You hockey fans are crazy.
Like, I feel like most hockey fans are kind of like nasty in a sense with their favorite teams and shit. Like, they either don't like them at all or fucking love it.
Mm-hmm. Is that true, nasty?
That's nasty. In a nutshell.
What you,
nothing.
Did you watch
I'm
Ryan?
Always all or nothing.
Did you watch Ryan Day's speech after after the game?
Mm-mm. He I was, don't think he did.
He was all amped up.
So. Yeah, I saw that, and I said something about it on my Facebook.
What'd you say? Hold on.
I said I never really liked Ryan Day, and I called for his head most of the times, but after watching the Notre Dame interview, I feel like maybe I misjudged him. He really does care and has some enthusiasm. He never shows that kind of, like...
Fire?
Drive or gumption or fire. Yeah, exactly. That's a good one. And for him to show it in the Notre Dame game, it was maybe he's, I don't know, maybe he's.
Well, he's probably got a personality like Chris, very, like, peaceful, I guess.
I hold you know, the anger inside.
Yeah,
it boils inside. Like
rage.
You really never know what you're gonna get.
Yeah,
face is the same all the time. I'm just kidding.
No, really. I make all kinds of weird faces.
You do. We have proof of that in previous episodes, for right. Sure. Go watch if you haven't.
Yeah.
And from Louder Than Life Pictures.
Yeah.
Oh, no, I just never know what my face is doing.
I wonder if that NFT ever took off.
The White China?
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe.
I
gotta check on that.
I go upload and look at the fucking wallet, and it's got like millions of dollars in there.
Well, just remember,
NFT selling.
Just cut me off like $500.
I'll cut you off like $5,000.
Hell yeah!
And I have the 500.
Hell
easy,
yeah!
Easy.
So we're all going to Vegas.
There's a stipulation that we have to go spend it in Vegas, and it has to be spent on hookers and or cocaine.
If we could go to Vegas, like, that would be an excellent weekend, I'm telling you. Vegas is a lot of fun. A lot of fun.
Well, we got to plan it then. Bang.
Yeah, let's do it. All you got to do is get here. I mean, I live like 8 hours from Vegas.
Yeah.
Or you could just fly into Vegas and I'll meet you out there.
That would probably be the cheapest route.
Yeah.
Because I think flights to Vegas are cheaper than flights to Phoenix. Because I think more flights go to Vegas from here.
Yeah.
Than,
I had to pay $90 for a plane ticket. For a 45-minute plane ticket from here to Vegas.
Dang.
Lousy bastards.
So. That's kind of cool. I mean, 45 minutes versus 8 hours.
Yeah. 45 minutes? Oh, yeah. No, I mean, I definitely was all right flying. I just thought it was a little like, I'm like, fucking $90?
Right.
So, anywho. I found this weird commercial I want to show you guys real quick. So, hold on.
Chris, did I tell you they took all my freaking my body spray and everything from me when I flew back home?
They took a bat? They took it from you? Like?
Yeah, they took my body spray, my cologne, my hair gel, everything.
Damn.
Why?
They said it was over 3 ounces. I was like, well, I flew here with it, so... He was like, well, you can check the bag. I was like, dude, I'm not checking the bag. Just throw it away.
It's like, damn it, man. Just give me my shit.
And, like, I'm just, the whole time, I'm just standing there shoeless. Like, can I at least have my shoes?
And they said, no.
Jeez.
You may not have your shoes. I just realized I had two of my mics going. So the first part of this podcast probably sounds like shit. Oh, look at that. It's 9 o'clock. Damn. So the entire thing sounds like shit. Womp womp. Oh, well.
Wow.
It sounds good now.
Damn.
So here's this video real quick. This video, this commercial that I found.
What's this?
It doesn't matter what comes, fresh goes better than life. With Mentos fresh and full of life. Nothing gets to you, staying fresh, staying cool. With Mentos fresh and full of life. Fresh goes better, Mentos fresh day. Fresh goes better with Mentos fresh and full of life.
Mentos.
What the hell?
Mentos?
Mentos, the fresh
the
maker.
Fresh maker.
Oh. That dude was fresh as fuck that whole video. Man, he whooped the shit out of both them guys, did like a sliding shooting thing. I didn't even see a gun in his hand. It looked like he did like finger bangs on that dude.
Oh, jeez.
What was any of that?
It's hard
that
to say.
That was wild. Like, it just kept going.
That's hard
yeah,
to
that
say.
That was a trip.
I don't know, but it was just a Mentos commercial. I came across that earlier today. I was like, what the fuck?
Remember the old Orbit commercials? Those were, like, the best.
Yeah, Orbit.
Or the,
oh,
my other favorite
pickle,
was
pickle
the,
your kumquat?
Yeah. Or the, Larry Culpepper, Dr. Pepper.
Yeah, I saw
commercials.
People are screaming for that to come back.
Yeah, they kind of fucked up and they
didn't,
lost me.
Didn't Culpepper get in trouble or something?
Did he?
I don't know. I think they just canceled his contract.
I'm pretty sure he got fucking trouble.
Oh, maybe. I don't know.
Let's find out here. Dr. Pepper confirms the end of Larry Culpepper. That was back in 2008. Yeah, Larry Culpepper. Who was... What happened to Larry Culpepper? He lost his job.
2008.
A
man
really?
Who
long?
Has annoyed college football fans over the past 4 seasons.
Annoyed him?
Maybe 2018.
Hi, it's Cold Dr. Pepper here. 2018. It says,
2008, I would have been in high school.
No, 2018.
Oh, I misheard.
Thank the good Lord above Larry Culpepper. Man, people did not like Larry Culpepper, I guess.
No.
Well, at least as far as some of these articles go.
You reminded me of Parker. Mike.
I'm trying to figure out where the...
Stick him in the Dr. Pepper suit for Halloween.
Jim Connor was the...
What?
His name was Jim Connor.
What?
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 I finished watching... Have you finished watching that yet?
No, I haven't had a chance to. I'm thinking about just starting it from the beginning with Mary.
Yeah, I finished watching... actually, last night, I finished watching it. Goddamn show.
Pretty funny.
No, I don't think Jim Connor got in any kind of trouble. Jim Connor, American actor. James Connor.
Too much.
James N. Connor. Yeah, I don't think he got in any kind of trouble. That's cool. Dr. Pepper here.
I must have drank about 13 Dr. Peppers.
He did drink a lot of Dr. Peppers. Anywho, what were we talking about?
What?
Dr. Pepper.
I don't know. Larry Culpepper.
Yeah, but he's nothing happened.
I thought it was Dennis Culpepper. Trouble.
They. I'm it was Larry. Larry Culpepper.
Larry.
She yells at us for not listening.
I'm sorry. I wrote it down wrong. Something just didn't. Right. I don't know.
Was there any other shit in the news here? The most intense heat wave ever recorded on Earth happened in Antarctica last year. Let's see. The best religious movies of all time.
Monty Python and the Holy Grail is number one.
Number one. And then what's the other one? The Ten Commandments?
Passion of the Christ.
Oh, the other Monty Python?
The Ten Commandments was Monty Python, wasn't it?
I'm confused. No. It was they had the Life of Brian.
Yeah.
The Holy Grail.
10 Things I Hate About You.
I don't think I've ever seen that.
He's like
Indiana Jones.
They're at the Coliseum or whatever, and he's like,
and the crystal
wolf
skull.
Nipple chips.
Yeah,
get them on their hot. Crazy. They're lovely.
Wolf nipple chips.
Yeah, like wolf nipple chips.
Like wolves.
It, like chips made out of wolves' nipples. Get them while they're hot. They're lovely.
That's fucking weird.
This just took a real weird turn. I'm not even sure what's going on anymore.
It's Monty Python. You'd have to watch it.
The writer's strike still going on. Oh, actually, it says right here that it may be ending soon.
Yeah, they said supposed to be ending
soon. Is the
soon.
Auto
They're
workers
starting to come to agreement?
Strike still going?
The auto workers?
Ford is still
or whatever.
Ford is still under strike. Josh has said something about it today.
Yeah.
Or yesterday, it hurt.
Who is?
Because you know he works for Hirschvogel. Ford.
Oh, Ford is. Yeah.
Ford
yeah. So
is
they're
under
still
strike or whatever.
They're still on strike. It actually says that the UAW strike is growing.
Yeah, I heard it was growing.
So
I didn't know. I hadn't heard anything since then.
Yeah.
So back on the 18th of this month, it was the fourth day of the strike. And auto worker strikes looms on the 13th. What is today? The 24th. Why is this so far back, you bastards? This is supposed to be the news.
I'm really glad you said today's date after you did my timesheet.
Oh, yeah. Today is the 24th.
The 25th here.
September said, see ya.
Yeah.
Yeah.
September's like,
September
hope you're ready to wake
a
up.
Bad month.
Oh,
wake
I know.
That guy up. Wake
Not
me up when September ends.
For concert.
Yeah. Oh, dude, Parkway Drive's coming next week.
Oh, are you
Parkway.
Gonna go?
I don't know, dude.
Dude, after seeing, did you see the videos of them from Louder Than Life?
Yeah, I did.
Oh my fucking god.
Yeah. So they're coming, and 3 Days Grace and Chevelle's coming.
Oh damn! I'd like to see both of them.
Yeah,
that'd be a pretty good show, dude.
Yeah.
So I wanted to ask you guys, what do you think about what's going on with Russell Brand?
What?
What's going on with Russell?
What did he do now? He's a psycho, dude.
Russell Brand's a psycho? What do you mean he's a psycho?
Yeah, I think he is.
He was a smart dude.
Yeah,
he's a fucking psycho, dude.
Well, he is being accused of sexual assault.
I believe it. But against who, though? No name person or another movie or person?
My understanding it was three...
Another famous person.
Three celebrity. Other women.
Damn.
Three women? Elder women?
I think you said 43 other women.
Four, no, three. Three women.
Oh. There's a huge misconception there amongst
yeah, I mean,
43.
Three,
he's just walking around
if it's
just
three,
everyone he meets. Hey,
if it's three other three different women coming forward, then it's most likely he's done something.
I mean,
what's the accusation? I mean, specifically.
Let's see. So he has been accused of rape and sexual assault by four women who who detail incidents that took place over 7 years, according to UK's Sunday Times.
Oh, he's a fucking psycho, dude. I was right.
Brand denies the allegations in a social media video during which he claimed that these encounters were consensual.
Yeah.
But how, I mean, you know, he's very vocal.
Until proven guilty.
He's vocal against the establishment, right? So he talks about, even in America, you know, what, like, he talks a lot about how.
He talks about a lot of American issues.
Yeah, and if you listen to him, he actually, like, it makes sense what he says, right? And he's all for people, you know, not being taken advantage of by billionaires and our government. God damn, what the fuck was that?
It was mom.
God, yeah. she all right? What the fuck?
Mm-hmm.
Is that pneumonia?
Needs to do her breathing treatments.
Golly. She needs to do something. Anywho, so I don't know. I mean, how hard do you think it would be for somebody in a position of power to find some women that he's had, you know, intimate relations with?
It's not.
And just I'm get sure and just be like, you know, here's $1 million if you say that you didn't want
to
do that.
I need all three of you to come forward, yeah.
Yeah, you just say that you did not want to do that.
Mm-hmm.
Well, if that's the case, then it'll probably just get found out and thrown out. Because that's typically how those work.
Yeah, that's how it works, and I'm sure that's how it's going to work.
Court, out of court.
But
I mean,
still,
Russell Brand's probably going to give them more than $1 million to keep their fucking mouth shut.
But it kind of
that's
kinda
the other way it works, right?
Tarnishes,
there.
You know. See, and this person was 16. Alice was 16, damn. The age of consent in the UK when she first dated Brandy was 31 at the time. All right.
Damn.
Well, I did not know
she
that.
She was dating him.
Yeah.
I missed that last part. What'd you say?
Damn.
She said Alice, one of the girls, was 16, which is the age of consent in the UK, but Brand was 31 at the time.
Damn.
Yikes.
I mean, I definitely, like, as a father of three girls, I'm like, okay, bro.
Well, now you believe me. Said, he's a fucking psycho.
Well, I mean, that just because, I mean, that's gross. And I mean, I don't know. That doesn't mean the shit that he says about what's going on with our way of life is not wrong.
With the world, yeah.
Doesn't.
But it says Alice said that she dated Brand for 3 months, during which she alleges that he groomed her and told her how to frame the relationship to her parents. In one sexual encounter at the end of their relationship, Alice said Brand sexually assaulted her when he shoved his penis in her mouth. Ugh.
Yeah, that's to a 16-year-old girl or a 30-year-old man.
Yeah,
that's fucked up.
See.
Holy shit.
God damn it. I don't know. I guess we'll leave
it
up to the courts.
Whatever, you know, I hope the courts find the truth. And
whatever happened with, what's his name? Marilyn Manson. Because he was in trouble for the same shit.
Was he? I thought his shit was for spitting on a cameraman.
No, he was in trouble for, it was sexual allegations.
Man, I don't know. I'm hoping that these things coming up are because, as a society, we've gotten to a point where that kind of shit won't be tolerated anymore.
Right.
You know, as it should be, you know, that shit, like, nobody should have to
feel like they have more of a voice,
right,
to speak up.
See, that's what I'm hoping it is, and not that it's like, you know,
something malicious.
Yeah, taking people down that speak out and tarnishing someone's name because they.
I mean, I'm sure that's happened in some cases.
I'm sure it has too. I don't know. We'll let the courts decide, I guess. I mean, I'm not anybody to sit here and judge. Because I don't know all the facts. But I don't know if that shit with Russell Brand's true, you know, that's fucking gross. You know?
Yeah.
But see, and that's what I'm talking about right there. You get that in your head, and it's hard to look, like, even if they come out and say, well, that's not true.
Yeah.
It's already seeded in there.
Well, yeah, we've already got a preconceived idea of what the fuck's going on, right?
Right. Yep. So I don't know. Fuck. Shit, hell, shit. All right. Well, I don't know. Did you guys have anything else you wanted to talk about before we...
Buttered sausage.
Buttered sausage. What it's doing. Why is it here? Why is it doing what it's doing? Get it out of my face.
Man, we had those buttered waffle pretzels, and those were good.
Oh, yeah. So, I saw somebody made, they took bacon, crisped up the bacon, and then battered those in pancakes and made pancakes stuffed with bacon. They were like dipping strips.
Yeah, Parker was telling me he just had some. Yep. It's true.
Gosh, so bad for you, but so good.
When Mary got her diagnosis about the hematomatosis, I was doing research about, you know, what foods to avoid and shit. And so I was like, well, shit, you know, we're having BLTs. I'll make hers with turkey bacon. Mm-hmm. And that was some of the worst, like, tasting and texture feeling food I've ever had in my life.
So
never again.
Really? So turkey bacon.
Maybe give it a different try with a different brand.
So turkey bacon, you gotta go in, like, knowing that it's not gonna be like regular bacon. It's not gonna be like pork bacon. It's got a different,
like it's like bacon you get from like a hospital.
Yeah, it's,
like not good. Like fake.
It's got
bacon.
A way different texture.
I air fried it, and like it crisped way too much, and it was like fucking potato chips.
Mm. Yeah, it cooks fast.
Yeah.
Yep.
I learned that. I had a client I used to take care of, and I would cook for them, and they had turkey bacon, and I burnt the shit out of that stuff. Damn. I was like, oh no.
Oh no, not the turkey bacon. He said, "Sir, I did you a favor."
Yeah, I've thrown out all of the turkey bacon.
Like I just cooked two more pieces and threw those away.
My stepmom used to cook, because when I was like maybe 10, 11, 12 in that age range, my dad started to develop a beer gut, right? So he went on a pretty strict diet. Like, he just put himself on a strict diet, and he cut out like all beer and soda, and he drank nothing but water. And then my stepmom cooked, she replaced a lot of like the pork and the beef with chicken and turkey. So we ate a lot of turkey and chicken. So
talking about food's making me hungry, damn it.
Yeah.
You ate dinner very early.
Yeah, you did.
Eat a snack.
I noticed that. I had a bunch of chicken wings, so I'm like stuffed.
I've been up
so
earlier than I usually have been. Fucking, I was playing fucking Diablo at like noon.
Yeah, I saw that. I was watching the Browns play.
Yep.
Hi. Anywho.
Pretty tired too.
Yeah, me too. That's what happens when you wake up early. You go to bed. anywho, yeah, I think that's probably good for tonight, huh?
Yeah.
Sure thing.
Yeah, it's what? Coming up on 9:30? 12:30, yeah. You guys' time. So.
Late.
Hopefully the audio wasn't too bad at the start of this deal. And, yeah, so we're going to end it there, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for hanging out and watching our podcast. We'll be back.
Yeah. Got 15 in here, it says.
Thursday night with another episode 32 of STFU on Driving.
Like and subscribe.
Check out the YouTube channel, please, and you know, subscribe to the channel. Oh. Help us out. Help us get our content out there. I do a lot of Diablo 4 and some other games on YouTube and Twitch as well. You can check me out there. See Kramer803 on YouTube and then Kramer803 on Twitch. Nasty does Diablo 4, dungeon runs, carries. Lilith carries on Twitch. Call me Nasty 8159. And yeah, I think that's it. So we'll be back Thursday with another episode. So check us out there. And until then, stay awesome.
Bye. Stay awesome.
Good week.
Good night.
Good day. Good night.
Peace. Bye. It's been a journey, man. That's it, and that's all.
Nothing else matters.
What happened to my 47 viewers?
So, like, I've had enough of this shit.
I thought we were playing Diablo on your stream, Nasty. Fuck is this shit? I tried.